Tuna Tefano, Scano Seguego. In a lot of my posts, I talk about this Flax line. So I figured instead of talking about it, I'd make a video and show you the process of making this. Alright, so helping me, and actually the person who introduced me to this, is my cultural expert and more importantly good friend, Rangi Ahipene. And here is the other star, the flax plant. So Rangi is going to run us through the cultural practice of properly extracting the leaf and then the fiber from the leaf.
Tēnā koutou, kia ora. That is the Maori welcome. Also want to say skano to my native Canadian cousins out there. Skano. What we're going to do today is we're going to show you how we extract fiber from a special plant, the flax plant, the Maori name being harakeke. Harakeke. Okay, the scientific name is Phormium tenax. So, first of all, we must acknowledge the plant and just and ask for the resource that we're about to take from the plant. So without further ado, I will say the prayer in Maori, and afterwards I'll give you an English translation. E te pāhara keke, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Ka nui te mihi atu ki ā koutou. Kua tai a mātou nei, hei whakanui ā koutou. Hei tono anō, māu etahi rau e tuku mai. Hei mahi a mātou nei, me whai mātou ngā mahi a ngā tupuna ki tēnei tumo mai. Hoi anō, tihei maurea. So basically what I said there, folks, is acknowledging the flax itself, because the flax is a living thing. Actually, in the Maori culture, we acknowledge the inanimate things and also the animate things. So this being an inanimate thing. But in the Maori culture, we are connected to everything and everyone. And so we're just paying our respects here. Now, if you come closer, if you have a look here, this is the shoot of the flax plant. On either side, you will find two supporting leaves. We call this the baby. And we call this, the two supporting leaves on the outside, the parents. Now, outside of these three leaves are called the grandparents. We never take the baby or the parents. In doing so, we could damage the plant and it may die. So we only take on the outside here. So I've got my sharp knife here, and I'm going to take a couple of these leaves, and we always cut on an angle going down. If you can see that. Okay, and I'll just take this other one going down. The reason why we cut it on an angle going down is that any moisture doesn't sit on the cut and cause rot and infection. Now that we've got the processed flax leaf, it is a little wide to manage, so we will be splitting it in half. If you come and take a closer look, you'll see that there are two different sides to the flax. We have a nice shiny side here compared to a dull side here. It's on this dull side which we'll be making a cut across the leaf. We place it onto a hard surface. Now we don't cut all the way through, so we can feel the fibers, the blade of the knife, just rolling over the top of the fiber, like so. Now if you have a look, this is what a perfect cut should look like. That's what it should look like. Now, we take our secret tool, which is, if you can have a look, a mussel shell. This is the traditional Maori tool for scraping or getting the fibre out of flax. We place the mussel shell, the straight edge, underneath that cut with the dull side facing up, and then we pull. There you are. See some of the fibre exposed already. What I'm doing is I'm just scraping off the membrane from underneath. Now, very important, what we don't use, we return back to the flax bush. This is out of respect and also for the practical reason that this waste can be reutilized by the plant, be reused by the plant when it breaks down. So we wrap it into a bundle, as so. Follow me. We go back to the flax bush and we put it under the flax bush from which we took it from. So over time, that waste will go back into the earth and be reused again. Okay, this is the final result. So to get here, we need to take our fiber, which is here. We need a leg, live one preferably, and our wrist. So what we do is we lay them side by side, the two strands of lots of fiber, and we pinch one end together so you form a V. We'll lay it across the top of the thigh, not too far apart, like so. Slap down, push, press down, and push forward at the same time until they join. Roll back. So again, until they join, and then there you are. You've got your cordage. This is another example of what the cord can be used for. If you have a close look, this is a fishing lure made out of power shell, hardwood, bone point, and this is cordage made out of flax that has been coated with a tree gum. The Cody tree, we've come here to ask for some gum so that we can gum this line. That's it. Thank you. That's it.
Nothing. Okay, the tree. You just come here to borrow some gum. Project.
So the sap from the Cody tree applied to the fiber line, what it does is it strengthens the fibers and binds them together. It's a bit like a Maori version of fiberglass. But what it also does is it just preserves and protects the line so that it's not susceptible to rotting. Now in my journey, I've taken it upon myself to rediscover traditional fishing techniques of the ancestors, the Maori ancestors. So you've just seen the hook, the lure, and now I'm going to show you that a line can be made as long or as short as required. Now this line is quite strong, so boys, bit of firmness. Tug on each end, please. Yeah, did that hold a fish, boys? Thank you.